everyone. My name is Kim Goss, and I'm a recruiter at the University of King's College in Halifax. Today, I'm going to speak with Charlene Salter. She works in our student accounts office here at King's. We're going to discuss some of the frequently asked questions that I often get from students when I'm out on the road. So, Charlene, can you tell me or speak to federal and provincial loans? Is a student supposed to apply to both, or do they just apply to one?
So students basically apply for one student loan. I know it may seem confusing, but behind the scenes, the federal government and the provincial government actually talk to each other, which is great for a student. So all the students have to do is go onto the website from which they're a permanent resident of, and that's where they apply for their student loan. So if you are actually a student from that is not from Nova Scotia, sorry, you would only apply through that province you're a permanent resident of. So regardless if you're studying from outer province, you can still apply for a student loan, which is great for students. I know there's a misconception out there that if I'm studying out of province, I can't apply for a loan unless I'm staying in the province. That is not true. Students can certainly apply for a student loan if they're coming here to Nova Scotia and they're not from here. So that's fantastic.
So when is the right time to apply?
I always tell students to apply for a student loan at least 2 months before they arrive. So if a student is coming in the fall term, they should at least have an application on file by the beginning of July. Some provinces will have an application open as early as May, which is fantastic. It allows students time to send in any subsequent forms that may be needed, and thus it will allow for the student loan, if they're approved, to arrive on time. So basically the student loan disbursement works in two ways. They will come in the fall term, and there'll be another student loan disbursement in the winter term. So if everything is in order and a student is granted a student loan, again, it will come in August for the fall term because tuition is due in September. And likewise, the winter disbursement will come in December, and that allows for the payment of tuition and fees in January term. There are some provinces that, although you get your first disbursement in the fall term, they will require you to send in subsequent forms. So not every province is the same, so just make sure you check your online student loan profile after you get your first disbursement, just to see if your province is one of the ones that you need to send in a subsequent form in order to get your second disbursement in time.
I know one really popular question is, do students have to pay back all this money that they borrow?
They do. Student loan is just that, it's an agreement, it's borrowed money that you do have to pay back. But I will tell students there are some provinces that offer different options in terms of repayments, and there are some provinces that also offer loan forgiveness. There are stipulations, and again, it's based on every province because every province is different. All provinces have fantastic websites in terms of their repayment options, so I encourage students just to have a peek at that. There are some benefits in terms of getting a student loan that some parts may not have to be paid back. And also there are, for those that don't fall into those categories, there are also repayment options which are very user-friendly for students, especially those that may be in a financial strain. They can work out different repayment options for students. So there's lots of flexibility when it comes to paying back your student loan.
Charlene, would you say it's better to get a student loan or a student line of credit?
So basically, it's a personal choice. It's all about having a financial plan, and it's what is best for you. Student loans have changed a lot over the years. And right now, I don't want to say it's a great time to get a student loan, but certainly from when I went to school, we didn't have all these options. So for me, looking and telling a student that's coming in, it really is much better than when I was a student. Right now, there are grants that are available for students, but you only are eligible for those grants if you apply for a student loan. So not all students are going to be eligible for them, but at least if you apply for a student loan, you'll find out if you're eligible for those grants. And again, like I said, the different repayment options, there's so much flexibility in it that to me it's a good option. You are interest free in terms of not having to make any payments on your student loan while you are in school full time, and then once you cease full time status, then 6 months after you're expected to start making payments on your student loan. Interest is accumulating in those first 6 months, but you don't have to start paying until the end of the 6 months. In regards to a student line of credit, if you don't get a student loan, then yes, there is an option to get a student line of credit. The difference with student line of credit is that you're going through a bank. So basically the student loan is through your government. You apply online through the province of permanent residency. The difference with that is that a student line of credit, you're applying through a banking institution. And the difference with that is that you have to make payments on it on a monthly basis. So that's the difference. One, you're not paying anything until you're done full-time studies. Student line of credit, you have to make a monthly payment. So it's basically what's best for you.
So what is the difference between a bursary and a student loan?
So a bursary versus a student loan. So a bursary is money that is given to a student that doesn't need to be paid back. I know that some people call it free money. We don't really like to call it free money. We like to say it's money that you don't have to pay back. Student loan, you do have to pay back. As I said earlier, you may not have to pay it all back. Some places and provinces have different repayment options and loan forgiveness options. Every province is different. But at some point, there will be some monies that will have to be paid back. Bursary, you do not have to pay back.
So what if I'm not Canadian and I'm an international student? How would a student loan work then?
That's a really good question because every country is different. So for example, if you're from the US and you're coming here to go to school, you can obtain financial aid. But I know there are other countries, we've had students from some countries overseas, and their country do not offer financial aid if they're studying out of province. So it's really important, like I tell students, to have a financial plan before they come and to do all this homework in terms of researching their country, in terms of financial aid assistance if they choose to study out of country.
So thank you, Charlene, for speaking with us today. Is there anything else that you think is important for students to know?
I would encourage students to check out our website. We have a lot of financial aid information on our website. And again, my name is Charlene Salter. I work in the Student Accounts Office. You'll find all my contact information there. And if you have any questions or concerns, I am always here to help.
Well, thank you, Charlene, and thank you for watching.